How is it going, everybody? And welcome back to the Minecraft Let's Play. I have finally made the skeleton XP farm. I mean, good gosh, we are like 20 episodes in, and I finally did it. We found this thing on episode 2. But as you know, I lost all of my stuff in the last episode, so I really, really needed it. Fortunately, I have pretty much gotten a good set of armor back. I think the only thing I really don't have is a helmet and a shovel. So, we're making pretty good progress. If you enjoy the video and want to support my channel and help me make videos in the future, consider becoming a member, where you'll be invited to my Minecraft and Discord servers, as well as have a chance to help me with new videos through exclusive community posts. Click the join button below for more information, and also thank you to those of you who have become a member since my last video. I mean, I honestly have no idea what I would have done had I not had that XP farm. I mean, it really, really saved the day. But that being said, hello everybody and welcome back to the Minecraft Let's Play. In the last episode, we got the Elytra, which was totally awesome. But of course, that was accompanied with also losing my stuff, like I said. But fortunately, we are looking pretty good. I got the fancy pants on. But that being said, let's go ahead and take a look at what's going on the inside. We haven't seen Phil or Vil in a while. Phil, they're here. I can hear the nose upstairs. They're always loud. What is this? Sincere apology by Phil Ager. Oh. As you guys may know, in the last episode, we all... Oh, there he is. I'm going to read it in a minute, buddy. We had a dragon egg, and presumably he clicked it, and I guess that's what he's apologizing about. So let's give this a good old-fashioned read. My dearest Z, 'twas indeed I whom broke the egg of the dragon. Upon being made aware of its existence, further inspections were made that ultimately caused the fabled egg's disappearance. I would like to offer my most sincere and deepest apologies. Thank you for your gift, bro. Sincerely, Phil Ager.
Well, Phil, I had no idea you were such a fancy pants. I mean, I should give these pants to you. Good gosh, that was a really well-written letter. Thank you so much for your apology, my friend, and it's okay. So I guess you broke it. Either that or it disappeared. We'll find it. We'll find it together. We'll probably have to scour the world and look for it, but ultimately, we will find it. Don't you worry, Phil. But how is Vil doing? Vil was the good one in that case, but he's never normally the good one. I see that you're updating your trades, which is good. It looks like we could do another trade. Let me go get some books real quick. By the way, to the person who said that I completely cheated and spawned all these books in, if you didn't watch the episode, we went to the stronghold and basically tore down all the books in the library. So that's how that worked. Totally cheated. Yeah, blah. All right, so where are you at? Dr. Vil, what can you give me? 12 as usual. That is exactly what I thought. I want to try something. Oh, did you update? Oh my gosh. Okay. Perfect. Perfect. Looking good. Go over there. Touch the book. The people said if I push him into it, that he should update. Come on. Go. You can do it, Bill. I believe in you. You're a doctor, for gosh sakes. Update. There we go. Nope. Okay. It didn't work. So sometimes it works. Other times it doesn't. But you know what? It doesn't matter. We got 24 emeralds, which is awesome. So we are doing pretty good, if I do say so myself. Speaking of Phil and Dr. Vil, Dr. Vil has made yet again another discovery that leads into one of the upcoming updates, Minecraft 1.16, that we are going to take a look at. But before we can do so, we're going to have to build something here in the backyard. Are you kidding me? The dragon egg this whole time has been in the backyard, just blocks away from its original placement. I mean, I'm not even kidding. It was probably like 10 blocks and it's right here this whole time. It's funny because Phil wasn't able to go outside to look for it. So of course he thought it was broken or gone. It's been in the backyard this whole time. But you know what? I don't think we should tell Phil. This sincere apology was amazing and I really don't want to ruin it by saying we found it the moment I read his letter. He's gonna think it's a prank. Which I guess at this point it kind of is. We're in on it. But don't tell anybody. This is our little secret. But for now, we'll just keep it in the backyard. I cannot believe this was back here. But anyways, I'm getting distracted. So, we are going to have... I still can't believe it. We're going to have to build a beehive here in the backyard. Because I'm going to need a lot of honeycomb. Because today, hopefully, we'll be able to look at the honeycomb block. Which was introduced at Minecon. Much like the goats and the mountain update and the nether update. So that being said, I'm going to discuss with Dr. Vil, see what I need to do, and we're going to build a little container unit for the bees and try and get a bee farm going on. You know, I don't even know why I try when it comes to landscaping. I always end up just breaking it anyway. So yeah, it's kind of sad. We got to break the land a little bit. I know it's very beautiful, but we have to do it. And that is so that we can actually build this thing. I want it to kind of have a similar style to what we've got going on here. So that being said, I'm going to try something I wouldn't normally do. And I'm also going to be extremely expensive with this build and use some anvils. I hate doing it because I don't have much iron to my name, but we've got to do it. It won't be that bad though. And as you can see, I put my tools up. I wish I didn't, but I did. All right, so what we need to do is place the blocks there. We're gonna have a little glowstone down here. This is just to get some lighting, really, more than anything. And then we're gonna have the other pillar over here. And I figured, why not use some barrels or whatever they're called, I can't think of the name, in this particular build. I feel like it would be very, very cool. Let's get some blocks going on here. Probably gonna put a barrel there for some storage, and we are looking pretty good. Now we basically just need to clear this out, get some glass placed in, because I am gonna have basically a large window here, just as an observatory style kind of build. So let me go ahead and do that, and I'm gonna go ahead and clear out some space behind it. And as always, my inventory is extremely messy. I mean, I really cannot seem to escape it, but that's okay. All right, so now we got to get a couple of decorations in place. As you can see, we got the inside looking pretty good, if I do say so myself. I need to go get a lantern, which I should have plenty of. We also need to craft a quick door. There we go. As you can see, this is what it looks like from the outside. Nothing crazy, nothing too special, but at least it works. I mean, it's definitely gonna look good once there's decorations inside, but for now, we gotta go get that lantern and do a couple of other decorations. This should help with a little bit of lighting. We should be good to go. And over here, what I want to do is actually put the beehives over here. And what I'm gonna do to make this work is add campfires. I know everybody has been telling me to do campfires, so that's something we're definitely gonna want to do. Because what it'll allow us to do is shear it without actually getting stung, which will keep our bees alive, which is very, very important. Because I don't really want to have to keep refilling this place with bees. That would definitely not be any fun. That being said, we're going to have the campfires there. We're going to have the beehives placed here. And then, of course, I'll have some stairs here to just kind of give it a little bit more room and open it up. And I'm pretty sure we're going to do the same thing here in the middle, just to kind of have that space. We'll put a chest there as well. But first, we got to change that around. My inventory is so bad. It's normally never this bad. There we go. Looking good. Looking good. I do need to basically put some water on these as well and change that out to be some spruce as well. There we go. Looking good. There's basically a ton of stuff I got to do. So I'm going to go ahead and decorate this place out, give you an idea of what I have in mind, and then we'll look at the final product. Everything has gone according to plan. This place is absolutely lovely. I love the way it's really come together. As you can see, we've got so many adorable little decorations kind of hidden all over the place. We've got flint and steel right here on this table, which we can actually grab to relight the campfire when we need it. The only problem is it's a little difficult to kind of put back in place, but that's okay. We've got the water bucket so that we can easily extinguish it if we need to. Of course, the shears to be able to then shear the beehives. We've also got some farms going on. As you can see, we got the wheat farm. Why not, right? I mean, if they're gonna pollinate it, we may as well take advantage of it. And then probably my favorite decoration of all is this. It's chainmail armor, which I got from my skeleton XP farm, which occasionally, very rarely, drops chainmail armor, and it looks like a bee suit, and I love the way it came together. It really fits this room. The only problem is I don't have the other pieces, the boots and the leggings, so we're gonna have to kind of work on that slowly over time. As I get them, I'll put them back here, but that looks amazing. All we really need to do now is get some bees, get them going, and get some honeycomb blocks so that we can craft the new discovery made by Dr. Ville. The bees are working. The only problem is these three, for some reason, are not going into the beehive block. I don't really know why, but hopefully you guys can let me know in the comments below. Three of them have gone into that beehive block, so we'll see them again in 5 minutes, but I don't really know why they're not going into that one over there. It could be that it's too close, which if that's the case, we can move it or something, but I don't know. Let me know in the comments down below. So the beehive is working, but it's not really working in the way that I thought it would. I honestly assumed it would be a little bit more productive than it currently is. I have managed to get a little bit of wheat, so they are doing a good job pollinating the plants. But I've really only gotten 60 honeycomb in about an hour or so. And that actually includes some that I've actually gotten from a couple of other places that I've been working with bees on. So I don't really think this is going to be as productive as the chicken coop, but it works, at least for this episode. So what I want to do is head up to Dr. Ville's office so that we can see exactly what we've got to do to craft this block. So if you don't know what I'm about to do, we're about to take a sneak peek All thanks to Dr. Ville at some blocks that are coming, or at least one block that's coming in Minecraft 1.16 that was shown off in Minecon. He is freaking out right now. He's excited. Dr. Ville, you have done it again. You found yet again another amazing discovery. So let's go ahead and take the book. I assume he's been writing. Dr. Ville Ager, October 7th, 2019. I've made a discovery for a new recipe for a new block. Hypothetically, crafting 9 honeycomb in a crafting table should produce a honeycomb block. So that means what we need to do is go ahead and try and craft that exact block. We need to make sure we put this back, otherwise he'll be mad. I'm sorry, Dr. Ville. I almost forgot, but I didn't forget. Don't be mad. All right, so I'm going to go outside for this. I want to find a crafting table out in the backyard just in case it explodes or something. You never really know with this kind of stuff. But he said, hypothetically, we could take 9 honeycomb and create a honeycomb block. Now, this is going to be one of the newest blocks in 1.16. So hopefully this works. Boom. All right, honeycomb block. Craftable. I don't know how he's done it, but he's managed to do it. Let's just go ahead and make as many as we can here. So the honeycomb block is a new block that's coming in the next update that's basically going to be similar to the slime block. It's going to slow you down whenever you actually walk on it. So if we kind of put a couple here, you can see it's actually doing that. And there's a couple of other interesting applications, but one thing I mainly like it for is the fact that it basically allows us to store honeycomb in a very productive way. Assuming we can decraft these back down to honeycomb, this is going to be very useful in the future. And as a side note, I honestly think we need more storage blocks. I think that would be fantastic. But anyways, I'm going to go ahead and try and set up another example and see if we can manage to get this to work. So another amazing feature of the honeycomb block is that it basically is going to act as some sort of slow falling mechanism, basically as if you're sticking to the surface. So I want to see if it actually does that in this particular example. So hopefully we don't die here, because that would be pretty bad. But I'm going to try and just jump down and see if it actually catches us. Hey, there we go. It works. So the slime block is actually going to be a great tool for getting down and up. Well, I assume up. I guess you really can't climb it. But it's going to allow you to kind of go down far spaces without getting hurt. I mean, we already kind of have different ways to do that, so that's not too impressive. But I'm sure there's going to be some really interesting parkour maps made out of that. So that is very interesting. Where are all my emeralds? We're going to need them for just a second because I just found another interesting use of the honeycomb block. And as you can see, we are nearly rich with emeralds right now. Ville and I have a really, really strong partnership going on. So let's go ahead and craft some blocks of emeralds just for the purpose of the video. Here we go. So, interestingly enough, if you place the honeycomb block as you would a slime block and actually attach blocks to it, it actually does move them like the slime block, which is very interesting. So, I don't really see how this could be useful considering we already have it, but what I'm assuming is that it kind of works in conjunction with slime blocks. So if you have the honeycomb block attached to a block and a slime block is mixed in there, it won't actually connect the blocks together. So maybe it could be used as some sort of channel system for the mechanic that the slime blocks offer currently. So I'm excited to see how this would work, but they did confirm that it will have redstone uses. So hopefully once it's actually in the game, we'll kind of get a better understanding of this mystery block. But anyways, that is pretty much going to be it for today's investigation into the wonderful world of bees and honeycomb blocks. They're definitely going to be exciting. I'm curious to see how they're actually implemented, which is going to be very, very cool to see. Oh, no, wrong place. Okay. There we go. All right, so I wanted to go ahead and get the honeycomb while we're here. Go ahead and grab that. There we go. I'm always afraid to do that because, of course, if my bees, which they're all over the place, if they sting me, they're going to die. So we always got to be very careful with that. But, all right, so now I'm slowly getting the hang of this. There we go. Looking good. You know, I'm pretty proud of myself. I've done some redstone, sort of. I mean, not really. In fact, no redstone other than a piston. I've managed to create a pretty cool little, I guess, process of a beehive here. So hopefully this inspired you in some way. If you're looking to make a farm, this is a really nice looking, you know, little building for a beehive. So Very, very cool. But let me know in the comments down below how I can improve the production rate, because honestly, it's not going too great. I guess I could always add more beehives in there and hopefully improve it that way, but I don't really know. So yeah. All right, so before we go, I wanted to go ahead and tell you that I do have plans to do some building. It's kind of been kind of weird over the last few episodes. We haven't really done too much. But that's just because we've really been exploring the wonderful new ideas that are coming to Minecraft. I'm very excited about the next update. It's going to be awesome. But before we go, I do plan on working on this. Hopefully soon we'll actually get to the pond part, because that was the whole point of this particular village. If we get in the air now, since we've got an elytra, which I love, by the way, you can see that this is actually shaped like a fish. So anybody who hasn't seen that before, that's basically why we're building this fishing village. But before we can really do any of that, I'm going to have to clean up the pond, and that way we'll finally be able to get to the part where we're able to essentially fill it up with fish named after all of you members. So thank you to everybody who's currently a member, because you will have a fish in the pond. But I do plan on working on another village as well, and hopefully some other projects soon, so definitely stay tuned. We've got a lot of cool building projects underway. But that being said, that is going to do it for today's episode. If you did enjoy, make sure to leave a thumbs up and consider subscribing and turning on notifications to be alerted whenever I next upload a video. And as always, thank you so much for watching and tuning in with me today. My name has been System Z. You guys have been awesome, and I'll see you in the next one. Thanks for watching.